Beyond Borders is basically an event we are trying to kind of organize as part of the larger Mumbai Pride Month activities. So the entire month of January has been a series of almost like I think 35 activities around Mumbai, which will culminate with the Pride March on February 3rd. So we're really thankful and happy that the Consulate General of Canada has actually helped us in organizing this event at the venue.
We're delighted to be supporting this event as part of Mumbai Pride Month.
Right.
We'd like to welcome Karim Ladak as well as our special guest here today. We're going to be talking, of course, about his book and his collaboration with Solaris as well and so on. But you know what? You're coming here to the Consulate General of Canada, I think, at a very interesting time. We're all diverse. We're all different. Different sexual preference. Different religions. We come from different cultures. Our families have different perspectives. The list goes on and on. But diversity is a fact, but inclusion is a choice, right? And that's where the leadership and the politics comes into it. And I also remember that I thought was very interesting that his father, Pierre Trudeau, once he was asked, you know, these were back in the days when in Canada we were debating what is, you know, Canada's national identity, how come we don't have one like the Americans, we don't seem to. And so he was asked, well, where's your all-American boy or girl up here in Canada? And his answer was basically to say that that was ridiculous. There is no such thing as an all-Canadian girl or boy. It's one kind of vision or way of being that we should all aspire to, because we're all completely different, and that's what we should celebrate. I want to thank Sridhar Rangayan, right? I want to, Solaris Pictures has put together a clip, I guess. We call it, you can call it more than that, can't we? That we're going to see today as well. I want to thank Karim as well for the positive messaging on diversity and inclusion, but your project in general. Karim has visited 166 different countries now. Not all of them are part of this book and this project, but 166, that's a huge number. I don't know anyone, even my colleagues retiring after 41 years in the diplomatic service, someone achieved 91, but this is really quite incredible. So to have his perspective, yes.
Parents of LGBT people, which was my commitment to you when we met, if you recall. I'm not able to honor that commitment, and for that reason I do apologize, but I'm so happy that many of you, but not everyone, is here, and we're celebrating this event together here. It's a nice consolation for me. And being Indian and Canadian, I can't tell you how just utterly emotional this moment is for me, because it intersects two identities that are so pivotal to me. And when you read the book, you will find out that I talk about, you know, cards dealt and cards played, meaning all of us have cards that have been dealt to us, and then we choose in life how to play them. And it wasn't until I had actually come out that I discovered I was utterly and completely Indian. It's interesting how that process of discovery takes place. Many people ask me why I use the word cosmopolitan, and it speaks to my philosophy of travel. Because I don't travel to get entertained in beaches and go to casinos and golf courses. In fact, I find that utterly and completely boring. As I would just going to a city and trying the different types of noodles, or, you know, I just travel to learn. I travel so that I see what is so much in common across all 7 billion of us. Okay, because there's a lot more that unites us than what separates us in life. And yet, with the rise of populism, we are led to believe that, you know, if you are not born to a certain race, sometimes socioeconomic group, that the other person is different. So my transformation in travel is about moving me from an I to a collective consciousness, we. So that's the cosmos. This is why the word cosmopolitan. And the more I travel, I tell you, the more I discover that, you know, the more I can look at you and go, I can find something in you that's me and bring it home, it's really, really majestic. Consider ourselves fairly progressive, but even in my family, when I came out in 1982, it wasn't easy. And it wasn't not easy because, you know, it was considered to be sacrilege or negative, but it wasn't easy because they had just not seen it before. You know, so I look at that kind of lack of education with a very different filter from I know.
Did you ever personally suffer from self-hatred
yes,
as a Muslim?
Yes. But I don't think that self-hatred is because of being Muslim.
Right.
I think that self-hatred was when I was 16 going on 17 and crying at night and, you know, writing suicide notes, and it was incredibly tough. But it was tough because I was trying to come to grips with my sexuality, but I was also away from home. I left home when I was 13.
And what does it make it harder for you to have stable relationships with people?
No.
No?
No.
Okay.
No. Because I think, you know, if it wasn't for social media, it would be incredibly difficult. But because of the social media, people actually are getting to know you in a very different way. If you are meaning a significant relationship, if that's what the intent was behind the question,
maybe
that's so not on my radar. You know, it, to me, it's like I never ask people why are they getting married, so why are you asking
so
me kind of thing?
Why do you think travel is important for us as humans in general, as queer individuals in particular?
So I think travel just opens up so much understanding about the world.
And who you already are as a person. Do you have curiosity? Do you have that empathy, compassion already? Because I mean, and not to be political about this, but I can think of two current global leaders who travel a lot and who bring no compassion back to their countries when they return from their innumerable trips. You know, they know nothing, absolutely nothing about humanity.
Refreshments, and feel free to post your pictures and tag us. We'll be happy to see all your happy faces. So you can tag us on Canada and India. And of course, our respect. Thank you, everybody. And a round of applause for everybody. Thank you for coming out.